When learning how to thread a serger, I always recommend that you start off with colors that match the serger colors and the codes. Then that way, as you get started, if the blue one doesn't look just right, you know where to kind of come back and know that this one is the one that's having some trouble. So I've gone ahead and put these on, and with the cones, we have used the little cone holder, and I've got it in such a way that when I push it all the way down, that it's nice and sturdy. So as the serger runs, they're not gonna wiggle. Now, up to now, we have had to thread a serger in a certain order, but with this new serger, I have found it's not really as crucial. You will see me thread the loopers first, so I'm gonna just work my way this way, and then my needles last. So this will be the left needle, this will be the right needle, and then this is upper looper and lower looper. So I'll try to call it by the actual item, not just by my green one. But when I come up to the top, I wanna just lay it in this little groove, and do make sure this part has been pulled all the way up to the top. Next, everybody needs to come underneath this first guide. Just hook it from the right, click it in, and if your presser foot is up, this is going to be ideal, because when you come down the groove for the tension dials, that means the tension discs have opened, and you can even kind of floss it in, and then that way you know that when that presser foot comes down, just like your sewing machine, it should be tight, and I can already feel it nice and tight now that I've lowered the presser foot. Next, open up the front cover and catch the first guide right at the edge. Now, if you pull out about 12 inches, you're going to have enough thread that when you go ahead and put it down the first hole for threading, and I want to make sure that my lever is towards the lower looper. And the last thing is I need to have this lever pushed over to threading. Now, if you didn't hear the click, give the hand wheel a little bit of turn. Let me show you. And then as you turn it, it will click into place. That is the tubes all connecting. So when you pump the air through it, it's just going to take the thread all the way through and send it out the looper. So lift up once and push down, and it will push it all the way through the lower looper. Now, if you didn't go all the way through, go ahead and pull out a little bit, slide it down a little further, and lift up again. There, that's the one I wanted. So I just didn't have enough little bit of tail for the air to take it all the way down. And we can just go ahead and leave that at that point. So I'm gonna come up with our upper looper this time, following the same path, raising up the presser foot if it wasn't already, and flossing it into those guides. Trust me, that's probably the most common thing that people have trouble, and their tensions. I always say, oh, the tensions are off. I'm like, well, most of the time it's just not in the tension. So if you can ever look inside here and you see your color of thread while you're sergering, all you need to do, that's the problem. Just lift up the presser foot, give it a little floss, and you're good to go. Okay, so I've pushed this down a little bit. Again, you can use tweezers if that helps. Switch the lever to the one you want to do. It's still locked in, so it's ready to send the air right on through, and there's my pink thread coming out this side. I love how fast that is. So when you're done here, you can actually just take the lever, set it over to sewing. So if you don't do this, that's not going to allow you to do anything. And what we can do, let me just cut that little, thread so it's not sticking out. Close the door, because now we're left to the needles. Let me show you how easy the needle threader is. We'll start with the right needle. We're really just following the same path as before. Presser foot is up, little floss, and then follow the arrows down and into position and over that top little guy. So it has to come in the mouth and then over this. Think of that as like your little take-up lever. Okay, one guide, second guide. Okay, next thing. You do need to, again, make sure your hand wheel is lined up. There's a mark on the hand wheel and a mark on the housing. Make sure that those two are aligned. Lower the presser foot and move the needle threader to be over in the R position. So if it's over at left, go ahead and give it a push. So it's R, this is the right needle. Pull the lever from the side all the way down and let it click into place. It will hold while you put the thread underneath the white part of the needle threader and then underneath the little hook. And then just go ahead and pull it straight up, and there is a loop of thread on the back side. So we get to practice that again. I'm gonna just send this little thread out the back. I could bring it just off to this side as well, but we'll just go ahead. Don't forget, switch this over. Now remember I said lower the presser foot to use the needle threader. So before I thread those tensions, I'm gonna lift that presser foot back up And then follow the groove. Once again, we're coming in. Don't forget to go over this little part. That's very important. And then the hand wheel hasn't moved, so all I'm going to do is lower the presser foot. We're over here at L. Lower it down. Let it hold it in place. Come underneath that white arm and up into the needle threader. And pull it right out the back. So now that there's four individual threads coming out the serger, you can just hold on to these threads and even start to stitch. You should start to see that famous serger chain coming out the back. And when you're ready, you can just take a piece of fabric. And I always like to take a piece of fabric, fold it in half, and you don't have to lift the presser foot up. Just put it right up to the edge of the foot and go ahead and let it stitch. I always like to cut a little something off on the side here, and then that way you can get a nice even edge. So you can pull just enough out here, and you can use the thread cutter on the side, usually from back towards you. Or if you want, you can bring that around, and I'll do that next, where we actually cut it off using the knife, and that the serger doesn't mind one bit. Okay, so what are you seeing here? We are noticing that we have a lot of pink going on, or red. That's the upper looper. A lot of lime green going back and forth here. That's the lower looper. And then the two needle threads that we threaded last, that is giving us that nice secure seam that can be used for four thread. That's called a four thread overlock, a great construction seam. It's very strong. If this was knit fabric, it's going to stretch just like you would want it to, but still hold together. So this is the classic four thread overlock that you'll see on most projects that you're probably doing.